Don's Breakfast Cereal Show. Thanks for tuning in. This is The Spider's Web. Now, we will be showing the sequel to this in a couple weeks from now. We don't want people to get confused with them back-to-back. So we're going to space them out a little bit. I believe our next one is going to be The Green Hornet. The original one, we already showed the return of The Green Hornet. This will be The Green Hornet. I was just sitting here looking over these pulp magazine reprints again, The Shadow and Spider. If I had to pick one that I would want to read the most, I would go with The Spider. He's always been one of my favorites. And thanks again for tuning in, and we'll be back. Thank you.
This master criminal has directed the underworld in launching a murderous attack upon major industries of the country in an attempt to break down civilization and reduce industry to a shambles. Richard Wentworth, famous criminologist, and the Spider, in reality Wentworth's other self, are making every attempt to locate the Octopus and bring him to justice. Begun a raid upon the airways of the nation with a death ray gun that crashed planes in flight, Wentworth threw his own ship in a desperate attempt to protect a mail transport marked for doom by the Octopus. His plane was attacked by the death-dealing ray gun and was sent crashing to earth in flames.
He's getting out the planes with high speed. He's done it. The fire's out.
Efficiency of flying has its reward. Here's a part of the ray gun. Someone has removed the identifying marks. There's just a slim chance that I can trace it to the one who made it.
What do you hope to accomplish?
The solution I have here will bring out what remains of the lettering that was filed away. The name of the manufacturer is not entirely gone. The microscope should make it visible. Take a look, Kirk.
Got something? Does that mean Mason is our man?
Either that, or he'll have to account for this.
night's work, Wentworth. I'll phone my office to have Mason picked up.
I'm not quite ready to make an arrest. I want to make some measurements first. You find any calipers on the desk, Nita?
No, Dick, they're not here.
Well, never mind. They're probably in the garden house. I'll send Jackson for them.
Teok the gardener, a trader.
Now, wait a minute. That's not Teok. Someone with a very clever disguise.
I'll stop him.
No, wait.
You're not going to let him get away, are you?
Yes. Just long enough to report what he's heard.
But Dick, he'll warn Mason.
That's just what I want him to do.
Yes?
Wentworth figured out the name on that lever. And Commissioner Kirk was with him and...
That'll do. What more on?
The activist wants to talk to you.
Yes, sir?
Take the necessary steps to prevent this clue from being followed further. Understand?
I understand, sir. Hey, get those rags off. We got a job to do. Any callers?
No, sir. Oh, yes. A boy brought a note a few minutes ago. It was marked personal, so I put it on your desk.
Thanks.
No choking, sister, and you won't get hurt.
Operator! Get me police headquarters!
Drop that phone. Get your hat, Mason. You're going with us. Been guilty, Sahib. Took his own life.
Oh, no, warrior. He was shot. Look there in his hand. Somebody get the police.
The men who did this are still in the building. The spider must strike.
But the police...
No, time is important. I'll get the guilty men for them. You stand by till they come.
Don't let anyone out of the building.
Cops! This is the fire escape in the rear.
Ramsey, you come with me.
Getaway. That's why they call him the spider.
spider can't escape. We've got all exits covered. Follow me.
Two of them went in the other room, and then there were shots and a crash.
Can you describe these men?
Wentworth.
Hello, Commissioner. This is Mason's secretary.
I know who she is, and I know who you are. You tricked me for the last time, spider.
Good heavens, Kirk, you don't still believe that, do you?
It's no use bluffing, Wentworth. The spider left his mark on two men out there. He can't get out of the building, and he's not trying, because he's right here. The spider got away from us, Commissioner. He used his web rope to swing clean onto the next roof.
Well, that's that. Since you can't be on that roof and here at the same time.
Oh, you will have to excuse me, Wentworth. This thing's driving me crazy.
This sample of Chase's handwriting is the nearest to that in the death note, but obviously it's not the same. There's a distinct difference in the way the S and the Y is formed.
You're right.
Well, we have one more specimen of handwriting to check, and then we will have covered our list of suspects. Joseph Cranes, vice president in charge of construction of the CRNO Railroad. This is it. We don't need a machine for this. The formation of the letters is identical.
Joseph Crane.
Hmm? It's perfect, isn't it? It's almost too perfect. You know, it could be a clever forgery. The Octopus is much too smart to lay himself open to such an easy identification of his handwriting. I'm inclined to believe that the Octopus deliberately forged Crane's style.
But why?
Well, that's quite simple. First, to divert attention from himself, and second, because he's planning an attack on Crane's interests. Let's call on Crane.
Couple more contracts for your signature, Mr. Crane.
All right, Carter, let me have them. Oh, hello, Commissioner. How are you, Wentworth?
Hello.
Well, I hope you boys bring good news.
Not so good, Crane. I'm sorry. You're under arrest.
Under arrest? Well, what's the matter? What's the charge?
You're suspected of being the Octopus. The charge will be murder.
The Octopus? Are you mad? Wentworth, this is your work.
Get your hat and don't talk. Anything you say may be held against you.
Well, this is ridiculous. It's an outrage. Now, Carter, see that everything is left exactly as it is. I'll be back here in an hour. All right, gentlemen, I'm ready.
Of course we knew it was a forgery. Your arrest was a measure for your own protection, as well as to get a line on what move the Octopus is about to make.
Well, I'm certainly relieved, gentlemen. I hope I can be of help.
Crane, I've just been arrested as I planned. Get the men and go at once to the construction job. You'll be joined there by runners, and we'll follow orders.
Howdy, Red Rose. I've been waiting for you.
See that none of the workmen are left on the job. Have the men watch the construction office, and you pick up all communication.
Now, the Octopus always opens each of his attacks with a campaign of terrorization. So far, your railroads have been unmolested. However, you should warn every one of your construction foremen.
Wait a minute. The new cutoff through Green Valley was opened this morning. They're going to run the first train through it tonight. Let me use your phone.
Certainly.
Green Valley office, Cadman speaking.
Hello. Hello.
Cadman speaking.
This isn't Cadman. Who is this? Hello. Something's happened to Cadman. He was on the phone a moment ago and I heard the sound of a blow.
Communicate with the state police. Crane, have that train stopped at once.
All phone and telegraph communications are cut to the north.
The radio.
We can't break through. Some powerful station has the airport static.
Get your squad cars up to that Green Valley job as soon as you can.
Hello? Hello.
Spider strikes again?
Right. Now you and Ram Singh get to the Great Crossing of Bolton Road and try to flag down that train. I'm going on to the construction camp at Green Valley.
Coming now.
train is due now. There she comes.
Wait a minute.
39 reporting. Spider just broke through the cut.
Spider just broke through the cut.
The spider interfering again, and for the last time, we let him get into the blast area and take him and the road together. Come on.
And in the next episode, you will see Richard Wentworth and Commissioner Kirk caught by the henchmen of the Octopus. The Octopus arch criminal wrecks a train carrying innocent victims. Richard Wentworth, as the spider, walks into a trap set by the Octopus. Will he escape? Known only as the Octopus, trying to gain control of all industry and commerce by a murderous attack of terrorization and destruction. Richard Wentworth, famous criminologist, and the spider, Wentworth's own creation, are aiding the police in their efforts to track down and destroy this menace.
The train is due now.
Wait a minute.
39 reporting. Spider just broke through the cut. It's the spider interfering again. And for the last time, we let him get into the blast area and take him and the road together. Come on.
The spider learning of another plan of sabotage directed at a newly constructed railroad branch has set his trusted aides, Jackson and Ram Singh, to head over the train which he fears will be wrecked. In another car, the spider himself speeds madly towards the camp, unaware that he is headed directly for the spot where a plan has been set that will throw the road he is traveling into oblivion.
Thank you.
I'm after two men who may be a clue to the madman behind it. What about this fellow?
He's Bradshaw. He works here.
All right, stand over here. You know this one?
Not my crew. Don't know him.
I do. One of his names is Burke. Take him in the office and keep him there.
Go on.
Well, maybe you can help by talking. Get him in the office. I found a couple of men who may know something about the explosion. Let's see if we can make them talk. All right, men.
All right, you boys, one outside.
What are you doing here, Burke? Come on, talk if you want to keep out of jail. You're a two-time loser already. We can pin serious charges on you because there were lives lost in that wreck. You know what that means.
I don't know nothing about the wreck. I wasn't even near it.
The wreck was caused by an explosion. You were near that. I saw you.
I was trying to get away from it. I didn't set it.
Then who did?
I don't know anything about the wreck or the blast. I was hired to guard the road and keep the people away.
Who hired you?
We did, pal. What about it? Stay where you are and don't move.
Hold it, officer. The commissioner's here.
They can't talk much now, Dick.
No. Looks like the octopus has won this round. I feel that we were very close to the octopus last night.
He's become bolder. He's bound to overstep himself soon.
I doubt that we'll catch him that way. He's as clever as he is ruthless.
Yes?
Chase, Mr. Green to see you.
Send him in.
I think I have something that may interest you.
Open that package, Commissioner. You'll find the hat and cape of the spider. It was found in the culvert last night, near the scene of the wreck.
Who found it?
My detectives. And that isn't all they found or saw.
No? What else?
They saw the spider go into a culvert. They started to go in after him, but before they could enter, another man came out. The opposite end of the culvert was blocked, so there was only one entrance, the one this man used. And they recognized him.
Who is he?
Richard Wentworth.
Strange, isn't it, Wentworth, that on several occasions you were discovered in a place from which the spider had just left?
Gentlemen, an accusation against me has been implied, but not made directly. I insist on one. In fact, out of fairness to myself, I demand that you make a direct accusation.
Are you willing to swear out a warrant?
Well, yes, of course. May I use your telephone to call my lawyer?
Certainly.
Hello, Jackson speaking.
Hello, Jack? This is Wentworth speaking. Yes, yes, I'll hold the phone.
I'm getting your finger tapping. Go on.
Yes, yes, I'm about to be arrested. I want you to go down and make arrangements as to my bail and so on. I'm in Commissioner Kirk's office. Yes, call me back here, please.
Yes, yes, Major. I got that. I'll attend to it right away. The Major's being held in Kirk's office. Get one of the cars. We're leaving at once.
Kirk speaking. Yes? All right. Your lawyer says he'll meet us in Judge Condon's chambers.
Gentlemen, at your service.
Careless of me to leave this where it could be found. It won't happen again.
After him! Catch him!
A spider, of course. I thought you'd caught the spider, Mr. Chase. You still want to swear out that warrant against me?
Of course he doesn't.
I'm very sorry, Mr. Wentworth. It was an honest mistake, motivated sincerely by a desire to help us all. But the evidence was really very strong against you.
Strong, but circumstantial.
I hope when we catch the octopus, Mr. Chase, it won't be by circumstantial evidence.
Well, what is our fair lady operative to report today?
Plenty. But whether it means anything or not remains to be seen. I've been checking on our suspects, both at their homes and at their offices. And only one of them seems to be doing anything which might be considered suspicious.
Which one is that?
Mr. Chase. He's been receiving unknown men in conference, both at home and at his office, and holding many conversations over a private phone he recently had installed.
Kirk's having him watched by plainclothes men.
Reason to believe he's gone away several times without Kirk's men knowing.
We'll have to do some checking about that.
Good afternoon, Mr. Wentworth.
Good afternoon. I'd like to see Mr. Chase, please.
I'll tell him you're here. He doesn't answer, but I'm sure he's somewhere in the building.
Well, I'll wait if you don't mind.
It worked. This looks like his new phone. Nita, look.
Then Mr. Chase has been kidnapped by the octopus.
It might look that way. But doesn't it seem strange that he'd have time to write this?
Then you don't believe it.
I'm sorry, Mr. Chase is not in the building.
Well, call the police commissioner and tell him that Mr. Chase has disappeared.
Disappeared?
It looks as though Blinky McQuade will have to take up the trail from here.
Gorman got his orders to grab Chase right from the octopus himself. I know that, Blinky. What'd he do with him? Gorman's holding him in that old factory on North Street. If you ask me, it's another gag to try and trap the spider. He seems to get wind of everything that goes on.
I hope he takes the bait.
Right, Blinky. You and me both.
Keep your eyes open. We expect the spider.
Here, this way.
And in the next episode, you will see Richard Wentworth trapped in the hospital room by the paid killers of the Octopus. The Octopus strikes at innocent victims by throwing poison vapor firecrackers into a hospital room. Wentworth, as the spider attempting to rescue his bodyguard, Ram Singh, jumps into the den of the Octopus henchman. Will he escape? To the underworld, a menace known as the Octopus is trying to seize control of the key industries of the nation. The Octopus follows this madman's dream with ruthless daring. Waging a desperate battle against the Octopus, Police Commissioner Kirk enlisted the aid of Richard Wentworth, famous criminologist. Into the contest leaps Wentworth's other self, the spider, trying to bring law and order to a terrorized business world.
He's been here. This way.
Until he discovered a suspended electric wire leading from the building. As the spider was crossing on the wire, his enemies dropped him in midair by breaking the wire insulator. As the strands unraveled, the spider hurtled through space toward certain death below.
Clear out. The machine is turned on full force, sir.
Good.
Now the chase has been eliminated as a possible suspect. We find that our search narrows down to three men. Gray, the banker, Gordon, head of the power company, and Frank, head of the broadcasting company. Now, Gray is a very powerful man in this city. But nevertheless, we must go on the assumption that he is the Octopus and let him prove that he isn't.
All right, unload him.
Gray could easily be the Octopus, Major. He has access to the cash in his banks.
Gray! What happened, Jenkins?
I don't know, sir. I found him at the door.
Well, who brought him here?
No one was with him, sir.
Please.
What?
Please. Please don't talk. I can't stand sound. The vibration.
Isn't there anything we can do for him?
Jenkins, call the hospital.
Yes, sir. Plain sound vibration, huh?
Hmm.
Use your case. Chart, please. Heartbeat rather faint. He should have a sedative to quiet him. His heart won't stand much more shock. And if sound excites him...
Doctor, it's important that I talk to him.
You may speak to him, but not above a whisper.
This is number 8 reporting. Wentworth with Gray now. He's going to question him.
They'll both be taken care of immediately. Keep me posted as to Wentworth's movements.
You wait here. After I take care of Gray, we'll tackle Wentworth. The intern gave us the whole layout. Easy, man. Go over there.
Wentworth's man, eh?
Yeah. We better grab him, Spike, and then you take him down to the chemical laboratory.
Oh, buddy. Have you a match?
By now.
Well, this man is dead. Have this case moved to the examination.
Yes.
Doctor, it's a case of plain murder.
This is a police matter, but first I want to make an examination to satisfy myself about this.
Mind if I go along?
No, no, come on.
Wentworth's in the examination room, end door to the left.
I heard of a case like this once, Doctor. Only it wasn't deliberate. Death was caused by the sudden slamming of a door.
The police ought to be here pretty soon.
That must be done now.
If I don't get out of it, you'll never see that guy in the turban again.
Ram Singh, where is he?
You'd like to know, wouldn't you?
Take him down to headquarters. We'll make you talk. Doc, where's your telephone?
Right over there.
Hello, this is Mr. Wentworth. Will you get my house, please? Hello, Jackson. I want you to get something and bring it down to headquarters. You'll find it down in the lab.
Sit down.
What is this?
Where did you get that?
You seem to recognize it. It's a sound vibrating machine like you used on Gray.
Let me out of here.
You know, Brahman, this machine has a good many uses. It might make you talk.
You can't do that to me.
Oh, no. You did it to Gray.
Don't turn it on. I'll talk.
All right. Where did they take Ram Singh?
I don't know.
I don't intend wasting time.
Turn it off! Turn it off!
Oh, no. We're going to leave you alone with it for a while. Come on, Jackson. Mr. Gorman isn't in a talkative mood.
I'll tell you, turn that thing off!
Where is Ram Singh?
He's at 10 West 4th Street, the chemical laboratory.
If you're lying, Gorman, you'll get worse than this. The police will take care of you. All right, Jackson.
No doubt the house will have some of the octopuses in there, Major.
I expect that.
Then the spider must strike again, huh? For Ram Singh's sake.
Right.
Wentworth is hard to discourage. But with you as the next victim he finds on his doorstep, he may stop interfering with the octopus.
Kate? Oh, what are we wasting time for, Trigger? Throw the mug in the shower room.
Sure. It'll be good for his health. Come on, we're going to give him a warm bath. Take it easy, Mick. May I be back yet?
Those men who escaped from the house, Sahib.
Jackson's missing, and we're still up against a stone wall. Not a clue. Well, I called you all here to discuss a plan. Ram Singh and I have a description of the men we think kidnapped Jackson, and...
Mr. Wentworth's home. Oh, just a minute, Mr. Kirk.
Yes, Kirk, what's up?
This may be a lead. Though it's rather vague. The council wants me to send a squad to the bus terminal to investigate the activities the public has been complaining about.
Thanks, Kirk. I'll check on it right away. The men are going to the terminal late tonight? All right. Goodbye.
The boys tapped Kirk's call to Wentworth. The commissioner's sending a squad of cops to the terminal tonight to investigate.
Very interesting. Commissioner Kirk's policemen will receive a warm welcome.
What will we do with Jackson, sir?
Hold him prisoner.
Round trip ticket for Lincoln Junction.
Sorry, but the terminal's closed for the night.
Closed? Well, you're not supposed to close until...
You heard what he said. They're out.
Who are you? What's the meaning of this?
Are you going to get out or do I have to throw you out?
I've heard about the things that go on in this terminal. Now I'm sure of it.
Now that you are sure, get out while you're still healthy.
I'll report this to the police.
All right, you guys. You've got your instructions.
next episode, you will see the spider escape the henchmen of the octopus only to run into the police. The octopus, in order to strike at Richard Wentworth, captures Nita Van Sloan. Richard Wentworth as the spider trapped by the henchmen of the octopus. Will he escape? A man known as the Octopus, one of the most vicious criminals of all time. In an effort to stamp out the rising wave of crime, Police Commissioner Kirk has enlisted the aid of Richard Wentworth, famous criminologist. The spider, Richard Wentworth's other self, leaps into the bitterly fought battle. His guns trained mercilessly on the forces of the Octopus. To prevent the attack. Finding himself trapped on a narrow window ledge, he was struck by a giant rock and tackled.
The spider, and he upset our plans.
Spider? Boss ain't gonna like that.
Come on inside. Turn that car around. I might have to get out of here in a hurry. First, the spider puts up the terminal party. Then, when we go after the newspaper, he knocks us over.
Between the spider and Wentworth, the octopus is fighting tough odds.
Wentworth won't bother us. We got his man Jackson with a shot of that firecracker poison. The boss is holding him prisoner someplace. Why, that guy's been unconscious for hours.
I got got to get out of here.
Where are you going?
Oh, I got orders to report the waterworks on 16th Street to get the layout.
The waterworks?
Yeah. Octopus has given orders to blow up the works and cut off the water supply.
Maybe I'd better report to the Octopus and get my orders. Yes, sir, I'm sure.
How did he get in there?
I don't know, sir. Nobody saw him come in.
Then I must assume that he heard too much. Report to me immediately. This force is my hand for the moment. I must work fast. I am going to see that Mr. Wentworth does not escape this time. I use two stones to kill one bird. Administer the antidote to Jackson.
He came out of it all right, sir.
Jackson, you're going to write a note to Richard Wentworth. You're going to invite him to come here and rescue you. But then, Jackson, I promise you that Mr. Wentworth will be cordially received.
Gave us. This is it. Lock that door. In here for breakfast. We'll plant Jackson's note on this guy and put him in the closet. Thank you.
that man. Jenkins, how did they get in here? What happened? That's what I'm trying to find out. Hi, son Jackson.
That doesn't sound like Jackson. He'd never ask me to stop fighting crime for his sake.
Wait a minute.
That's not Jackson's regular style. It's written with his left hand. He's warning me to stay away. It's a trap with Jackson as the bait. Well, we know he's alive, though we don't know for how long. I'll get an antidote ready. He may be in a coma when we find him. Put a drop of that snake poison on a slide, will you?
Don't! Don't touch that!
Why not?
There's high explosive in those tubes. We put them there.
Lamb, phone Kirk and tell him to pick up these men. I'll be down at his office soon.
Cheers, Jenkins.
I'm right. If I'm right, this'll do the trick. I've got it. Now I remember that white paper. I saw it used in Rangoon. The poison of the Ringles cobra.
Snake poison, but how?
Well, this particular cobra doesn't bite its victims. It sprays its poison in a vapor.
But nothing sprayed this poison, sir.
Ah, you're wrong there. The explosion of the firecracker released the gas from a glass vial and sprayed it in areas as far as 12 feet. Hope I can get to Jackson in time to administer this antidote.
Commissioner says he'll take care of these men immediately, Sahib.
Good. If Nita phones, tell her I'll contact her soon. I'll be at Kirk's office.
Van Sloan? This is Officer Brooks of Commissioner Kirk's office calling. Mr. Wentworth asked me to call and ask you if you can come down to headquarters immediately. We'll have a taxi call for you.
Certainly, I'll be ready in a minute. Thank you. Mr. Wentworth just phoned Ram Singh. I'm to meet him at Commissioner Kirk's office. Are there any messages for him?
No, no other messages. Goodbye, Ma'am Sahib.
Goodbye.
Miss Van Sloan?
Yes. Did Mr. Wentworth send you here?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
Brings you gentlemen here so early this morning.
Well, we all received quite a scare from that bus terminal business.
Undoubtedly the octopus again.
I understand that the spider did a good job in helping to prevent the massacre of the policeman.
Newspapers make a hero of him.
I'm inclined to agree with the newspapers.
As far as the police are concerned, he's still an outlaw.
Have you had any word about Jackson?
Yes. Where is Jackson? And what about that note from him?
Oh, yes. I was just going to tell you about that. I don't know how Jackson got this to me, but I'm going to follow through on it at once.
I'm sure with the fine work the police have done, it won't be hard to find Jackson. I have a conference in a half hour, gentlemen.
I must be at my desk. You're making progress. Keep up the good work.
Commissioner, if I can be of any further help, why, please let me know.
Cook, I didn't want to scare those men, but I found out there's going to be an attempt to blow up the city's waterworks tonight.
The waterworks? Yes.
And that note from Jackson is a trap.
But you said you were going to follow through on it.
I am. It's the only lead I have.
But you can't do it alone. Let me send my men.
No, it may be an attempt to draw us away from the waterworks. You've got to detail men to cover those areas. And besides, a raid on the place where they're holding Jackson would be too obvious. In working alone, Kirk, I have one advantage. The octopus doesn't know I'm aware of his trap. I shall step into it deliberately, but prepared.
I'll send a squad of men to each water plant immediately.
Good. I'll see you later.
Wentworth is going to try to arrest you, Jackson, led on by my note. One of you will be disguised as Jackson. And when Wentworth arrives, we will be ready for him. This time, Richard Wentworth does not escape.
Jackson, hello, sir. Has Nita called?
Yes, Sahib. She said she was going to meet you at headquarters, that you had called her.
At headquarters? I didn't call. There's no answer. They've got Jackson and Nita now. The spider must strike, even though he steps into the trap of the octopus.
As the prophet saith, it taketh more than honey to catch the bee.
Wait here until I call. Ram, come with me. We can make the old Gladstone house by dusk.
Now listen, everybody. Wentworth will be here any minute. And you, remember, you're supposed to be Jackson, stretched out on that couch.
Hurry, Ram, sing, step on it.
You men stand guard outside the house to make it look better when Wentworth gets here. And don't try to shoot it out with him, because he's too fast on the drawer. Let him get into the house. The minute he gets over to that couch, we'll have him.
Cut your motor and coast in.
Ready to start quickly.
Wentworth, as Blinky McQuade finds himself trapped by the paid killers of the octopus. The spider defies death by running up a 60-foot ladder with the police after him. The spider and the octopus face to face. Who is the victor? Who is the octopus? Mysterious master criminal has led the underworld in attacking the major industries of the country. Police Commissioner Kirk enlisted the aid of Richard Wentworth, famous criminologist, to stem the rising tide of chaos and destruction. Into this fight against the wave of crime stepped Wentworth's other self, the spider.
Ready to start quickly.
Wentworth was receiving information of the capture of Nita Van Sloan and Jackson, disguised himself as the Spider and went to the house where his aides were held captive. The Spider made a stealthy entrance into a dimly lighted room. There he saw a man whom he took to be Jackson lying on a couch. Rushing towards him, the Spider stepped on the trap door and was pitched headlong into the basement.
Us from now till doomsday, and you get nothing out of us.
May interest you both to know that Richard Wentworth has already walked into a trap.
The mark of the spider.
Let Wentworth escape.
Wentworth did not come. The spider came.
The spider seems to hover over Wentworth like a guardian angel. But neither of them will escape me. Where are the men you took with you?
They're dead. The spider.
Your failure isn't lessened by the fact that it was the spider who escaped you. You are dismissed. No! Not that way. Through that door.
Place my hand on the man who calls himself the Octopus. He was in the commissioner's office this morning, and he overplayed his hand. But I've got to face him in his lair. Catch him in the character of the Octopus.
You know the Octopus?
I think I do.
Well, why don't we go get it?
First, because an arrest at this time would seal the death warrant of Nita and Jackson. Second, because I need absolute proof. Now, it might be found in the man's office, and Blinky McQuade is just the fellow to look for it.
Can't see very well. Okay, here we go, Blinky.
Excuse me, sir, but why would a man lock a bulb like that in his safe?
Oh, this is no ordinary bulb, Jenkins. This is what is known as a deflection tube, designed for specialized radios. There are very few of them in use, and they have to be installed by an expert. I'm waiting now for Wilson of General Radio to call and give me some information.
The Sahib might test out the television set that was installed on the telephone today.
Yeah, that's an idea. Wilson should have something by now. I'll call him.
Wentworth?
Yes, Wilson. What have you got for me?
We've only installed three tube sets in the city.
Only three installed in the city, huh?
And there's a special installation at 413 First Avenue, on the sixth floor, some kind of a private technical school.
413 First Avenue. You installed it there?
Yes, months ago.
All right, thanks, old man.
You're welcome. Good night.
Good night.
I want to spend
This is Richard Wentworth speaking.
I'm delivering my final warning. Any further interference on your part will jeopardize the lives of my prisoners.
You seem to have no fear of phoning me.
Fear? Of you? That you should have fear of me?
Very courageous, Mr. Octopus. This calls for a personal visit to you.
You'll have to know me first to find me. And don't forget, my prisoners.
Light. Find him, Master?
There's a chance. He spoke from some place that's within the radius of a mile from here. Get me the map of the city. I'll draw a circle with a radius of 1 mile using our place as a center.
Your line cuts the intersection of First Avenue and 4th Street.
Right. That must be the place where Wilson said the tube was installed.
Then let us attack, Monster.
Steady, warrior. We've got to look the place over and plan our action.
Wait, Ram. The Octopus won't leave the place unguarded. The man on the door is trying to be a lookout.
You go in, Sahib. I'll take care of him.
Yeah, but quietly, warrior. There must be no alarm. Wait here, Jenkins.
Sentry will not bother, Sahib. Have you found the place?
No, but there's something peculiar here. There's a complete wing of the building that seems to have no entrance.
Then that's where the beast hides, Sahib. We must get to him if we have to break through solid walls.
I have a better idea than that. Let's get back to the car. Get me some smoke pots, Jenkins.
Yes.
Ram, come on. Those other smoke pots. Stand by to whack quickly.
Thank you.
Will you walk through that door alone, or do you need the assistance of my men?
Don't move, Octopus!
So you finally found me?
Yes, with your help. You were a little too sure of yourself on numerous occasions. I must have been blind not to know you sooner. But when you mentioned that note in Commissioner Kirk's office, you disclosed knowledge that only the Octopus could have.
So you are Richard Wentworth.
Too late for that knowledge to be of any value to you now.
It's never too late. Nothing can change my destiny.
Get Nita out of here quickly, and remember, you know nothing of what happened.
Yes, sir.
Hello, Kirk.
What's up?
The spider's in the building. He's somewhere upstairs. Say, what are you doing here?
Well, I phoned your office, and they told me.
Come on, all right, all right. Don't touch anything, man.
There's no doubt that this is the den of the Octopus.
You're right, Wentworth, and that must be the fiend himself.
Chase. So that's why the spider came here. It's odd, Wentworth, that you always appear where the spider has left his mark.
I'll grant you that, Kirk. But you'll have to admit that the spider did us both a good turn today. Now, this time I really mean it, Nita. We're going to get started on our honeymoon today.
Then the spider is dead?
No, not dead. Shall we say, just retired for the time being?
I hope it's a permanent police department, please.
Well, where is it?
I fell through all the padding, Shaky. I turned the joint upside down. It just ain't there.
That map's got to be there. And we're getting it. Wait here.
Police department? Somebody just broke into my apartment. No, no, I don't think they stole anything, but they slashed the upholstery. Yes, that's all. I can't understand it. Oh, Cherry Yates. 144 Booker Place, apartment B. Yes, that's right. And I think... All right, I'll hold on.
Yes?
Tracy?
Now, this is Sam Ketchum. Tracy's out trying to find Shaky.
Shaky? He just got out of jail today. What's up?
I was trailing him, and he got away from me. Now, Tracy's after him. He should be back soon.
I got a call here from the Booker Place apartment. Tracy told us to notify him if anything turned up there.
Booker Place? Oh, that's the old Shaky hangout. Switch that call over here. Take Tracy's office. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Well, Tracy should be back soon. Then we'll be right out.
Good. I'll be waiting for you.
She's expecting the police.
We better get out of here. You just done a stretch. This place is getting too hot. It's not worth it.
That map will tell us where the Malcolm City Bank loot is. That's over $100,000 cash. I'm broke. I've got to have it.
Okay. Okay, Shaky, I'm with you, but let's play it safe.
You leave that to me. We'll wait 10 minutes. Then we'll move back in.
Yes? Who is it?
You phoned the police, lady?
I didn't know that you could get here, sir.
Jam that door. Take care of her.
What is this?
Look, we've got no time for games. For any interference. Now get this straight. Either you sit down in that chair over there or Buck will tie you up. Make up your mind. And keep quiet. Give me a hand.
Can't we take these things out of here?
No, there's no time. Besides, we might be spotted. Now, hurry up. He said we'd find it here. Goldtop never made mistakes.
He made one. He stopped a cop's bullet.
Look, that was an accident. He said it was here. It's got to be here. Maybe it's that one of yours. Let me have a look. Reupholstered March 16th. That's before Blowtop was killed.
If Blowtop had him recovered, he must have had a reason for it.
Barksdale Upholstering Company. Answer it. Be careful what you say.
Hello?
This is police headquarters calling. Dick Tracy. You phoned me a while ago?
Yes. Yes, I phoned. It's the police.
Tell them it was a false alarm.
I'm sorry. I made a mistake. It was a false alarm.
Is it false or is it an alarm?
Yes.
Is there someone with you? Are you in danger?
Yes, thank you.
Stall them if you can. We're on our way. The woman's in trouble, Sam. Come on, let's go.
It was a Mr. Tracy.
Dick Tracy?
Yes, he said he'd be by in the morning.
For that, you get a gold star. Now go sit down. We've got to work fast.
Fast ain't the word for it with $100,000 on the loose.
I told you before, you talk too much.
She don't count, boss.
Maybe not.
Now she knows what we're after.
That's no problem.
We can't risk the noise. Tie her up.
Now what, Shaky?
Over there. Close the doors and windows.
Wherever she went, she left her stove on.
Quick, Sam, lean against this door.
Yeah.
The window.
Miss Yates, just breathe deeply. Take it easy. You'll be all right. Sleeps back there, Kenny.
You see, Shaky used to run with a mob that made this apartment their headquarters. After the last big bank robbery, the mob was broken up, killed or jailed.
And this Mr. Shaky?
Oh, he's been in the jug. Just got out yesterday.
But why would he want to come back here?
Well, the bank money was never recovered. We've always suspicioned there was a clue hidden here somewhere. We've searched the place many times, but never found it.
Well, why would he pick on my lovely chairs?
I don't know, unless he felt that they held the answer.
Well, the only thing that seemed to interest your Mr. Shaky
oh,
was...
please, not our Mr. Shaky. Not yet.
Well, the only thing that held his attention was the label underneath.
The label?
Like Shaky wasn't taking any chances.
Well, Sam, maybe some more of this furniture was redone at the same time. Here's one, Sam. And the date on it is just before we broke up the mob.
Maybe this fellow Boxdale saw something when he did the job.
We'll soon find out. You stay here and keep an eye on Miss Yates. They might come back. Thanks.
Looks like you're a good businessman. You keep neat books. See, March 16th. No entry. 15th. Nothing. 17th. Not such a good businessman. You'd better have a good memory. What about a job for Blowtop? Booker place, two armchairs.
Blowtop. Oh, yes, I remember now. A reupholstery job.
I'm surprised you didn't enter it in your books.
Well, I must have forgotten.
You're smart. You won't forget anything.
Please, don't. Don't.
Did you find anything in those chairs?
Anything? No, nothing. I swear it. I'm not lying.
Was there anything unusual about the job?
No, nothing. I don't know anything. All right, I'll tell you. Blowtop had me drill a hole in the front leg of one of those chairs, under the caster.
Now, why didn't you tell us that in the first place?
Well, Blowtop promised me $1,000 if I'd keep it to myself.
I see. Okay. You get the dough? But only because I might be able to use you. This would make a good hideout. If you ever squeal, if you ever say one word to the cops...
Oh, no, I wouldn't. Honest, I swear I wouldn't.
See, you remember that. Let's get those chairs. I don't get it, Tracy. Why the gun?
Hey, you ain't got nothing on us.
Oh, not too much. Just burglary, assault, vandalism, impersonating police officers, and a little thing like attempted murder. Been having a good time tonight? Now get in the other room. I want to talk to Barksdale. Go on. Barksdale!
Oh! Now you know whose side I'm on.
That 1,000 was peanuts. You won't be sorry.
What now, Shaky?
Closet's a good place.
Yeah, in with it. You may need this.
That could be.
I haven't any idea.
Barksdale was right, eh, Bucky? Well, well. Flatfoot caught, flat-footed. If you don't mind. Time up.
Sit down over there.
Can you get your head down to my hand? Down, down, a little further. That's it. Good. Now, you see that watch on my wrist?
Yes.
Well, it's not a watch. It's a radio, a two-way radio. I've got to get to Tracy. Now, listen. The little switch on the side? Mm-hmm. Push it.
That one?
That's the one.
Go ahead, Sam.
We're tied up in Miss Yates' apartment. Shaky was here. He got the map. We found it. You better get over here as fast as you can.
That's easier said than done. They got me, too, at Barksdale's. What about the map? Do you remember any of the details?
Well, it was something about a cafe with large circles around. Looked like manhole covers.
Oh, I think there were tables.
Well, maybe so. It said, cafe down. And it was sort of a,
long box on the side.
It said planter box.
Anything else on it?
Well, on the top it said 12 DA. I can't figure it out.
12 DA. I've got it, Sam. It's 12th Street and Dougal Alley. It's the Alley Cafe. Now listen, Sam, I'll get to you somehow.
Barksdale! 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 Be at the cafe soon. We'll have to leave you alone. I'm sure they won't be back.
I'll be all right, thanks.
I took my gun, Sam. I'll have to have yours. You've been a great help, Miss Yates. Thank you very much.
I couldn't find you, fellas, and I thought that maybe what you were trying to find was here, and so I thought I would help you find it. For us. That's it, for us.
Isn't that nice? What do you think, Buck?
I think this guy's too nice to live.
Oh, no. Shaky. No. No. I was...
dig in this area.
That it, boss?
I think so. There.
Gee, $100,000.
Too bad you can't spend it.
Who's flat-footed now, Shaky?
It's the end of the line, boys. Sam, call the station. Have them send a wagon.
Yeah. Tracy.
Miss Yates, what is this?
Drop those guns, boys. All right, now kick him over here.
Is this some kind of a joke?
I'm not much of a comedian, Mr. Tracy. It's
Suppose you could call it a payoff. Shaky's been owing it to us for a long time now.
Us?
My brother and me. Shaky made a chump out of him time after time. He almost did it again on this job.
Who is your brother?
Your tense is wrong, copper. He was Blowtop.
Blowtop? Your brother?
That's right, Shaky. And he wrote me all about his wonderful pal, Shaky. His wonderful double-crossing pal. He just about made up his mind to do something about it when these cops got him.
So you rented that apartment purposely?
To find the map? And I can thank you and Mr. Ketchum for that. Now hand over the money. Find Mina Tracy. I want that money. Pick it up, copper.
Okay.
You asked for it, Tracy!
Nobody's taking that money. Nobody but...
That's it. Well, that goes for you, Birds, too.
Just a shoulder wound. She'll get over it.
Well, she almost got away with it.
Yeah, so did her brother.
So do most crooks. Almost, but not quite.
Remarkable physical strength, Superman fights a never-ending battle for truth and justice. Disguised as a mild-mannered newspaper reporter, Clark Kent.
Your assignments. Hurry over and cover that consumer's meeting.
But, Chief...
But nothing. That's final.
Was a close call. I've got to get to police headquarters immediately.
You're damnless in shock, Skipper. I send you out to bring back that woman, and what happens? You let her get away and bring me this fool. She must not get to the airport. She must be stopped.
They are probably the largest and most ruthless gang of saboteurs in this country. I know. For 6 months, they thought I was one of them. This briefcase contains a list of their names, together with their diabolical plans of destruction. They will stop at nothing to recover these records. I must get them through to Washington.
I understand. I'll see that you have an escort to the airport.
She's heading this way. Quick! On the bridge.
But the place is surrounded by cops.
Hello? Edridge? Hello? Hello? Zum Donnerwetter. Something went wrong. We've got to get those records.
Again, this is Don O'Malley with Don's Breakfast Cereal Show. Make sure you check us out on Facebook and Earlier I had stated that the spider was a ripoff of the Shadow. He was. But if you can think of Street and Smith, who published pulp magazines back then, they had Doc Savage, The Avenger, and The Shadow, three top sellers. Now, Popular came up with their own. Popular Publications came up with their own set of heroes. They were the Spider G8 and Operator 5. Now, to give you some idea, if you can relate to DC Comics and Marvel Comics, you can treat Street and Smith as DC Comics and Popular Publications, Spider, and the rest of them as the Marvel. So they were more intense over there at Popular Publications and fun reads. They're very fast and inexpensive nowadays for paperbacks and that, and reprints. So here we go again. Thanks again. This is Don O'Malley with Don's Breakfast Cereal Show.